respected Joint Director CIET, Dr. A.P. Behra, sir. It's really true blessings for us that, but because of your leadership and dedication towards our different uses of technology in the school education, it's an auspicious moment for me that has been asked to share and upload a session about National Education Policy 2020, especially in Section 23 and 24. As a matter of fact, it's need of the hour for Indian schools, and as I saw and read, which is crystal clear in every aspect of Indian constitutional ethics and values. Now, I am very much concerned about the Section 23 and 24. Section 23 focuses on technology used and integration. The policy document clearly submit and admit that, number one, the Digital India campaign helped in transformation of entire India into a digital empowered society. Number two, in present scenario, it can be seen that creativity of teachers and students that how artificial intelligence and other form of machines are helping that what and how they are learning. Number three, an autonomous body, National Educational Technology Forum, NETF, will be established for the rigorous and transparent evaluation system. Next, NETF will organize a regional and national conferences, workshops, training, etc. Number five, the purpose of all technological and interventions are for the real-time measurement of education. Number six, learning and e-content development by the academic institutions, state board will be uploaded to the TikTok portal, and CIT will be all in all to look after the e-development work and strengthening of the technology. The same way, next, there must be more attention for disruptive technology in education to refine the competencies of learning, to understand the potential of artificial intelligence, virtual realities, and the trend of professional use must be incorporated and looked after by NETF. Another way, National Research Foundation, NRF, will be initiated or created on research and technology. Higher educational institutes will involve the research work on disruptive technology and will discover the training as well for the stakeholders. The universities will offer PhD and master degree program in machine learning as well. The awareness program by NETF or MHRD regarding disruptive technology and its impact will be taken care of. Means in the meantime, they will advertise the going on awareness program of the disruptive technology. Finally, this section talks about data handling and its privacy. Its monitoring is must, and as data is supposed to be fuel energy for artificial intelligence, so its handling must be taken care of. The next section, 24, the same way, is talking about online and digital education. That it clearly mentioned that ICT-based educational institution must be optimized and expanded to all for quality education. The same way, it says that digital divide must be eliminated for the concern of equity. Next, it also suggests that teacher must be upgraded as an expert online educator. The next fourth point, it says that the importance will be given on online education, digital infrastructure, online teaching platform, and tools like Swayam and Diksha. There must be content creation focused on virtual labs, virtual reality, online assessment, evaluation by the different agencies like NAC, PARC, and NDA will be design and implement all kind of assessment for transparency in real-time basis. At the same time, it also tells finally about how world-class digital infrastructure can be established. It will be in the form of a center where experts of different fields like administration, education, education technology, digital pedagogy, and assessment experts, e-governance experts will be available around the clock to look after the digital interventions in the whole country. Finally, in my submission, I would like to add about NEP 2020 that our teaching must be upgraded, teacher must be upgraded by 2020 or before across the country. Every villages must have satellite communication, loom or power communication. In remote schools of India must have e-resources online or offline facility where each and every villager can distribute the content for their kids. At local level community center, there must be smart TV or e-content available by the Department of Education, or it must be distributed under district magistrate or pradhan or ward member to help the student of each family in the remote area.